On this day, November 19, 1821, birth of Don Ponciano Leiva. He was born in Sehuaca, Santa Barbara, on November 19, 1821. His parents, Marcos de Leiva and Presentación Madrid, he married Luisa Castro Acosta in 1858. He issued the Organic Law of Public Instruction on September 15, 1874. He authorized the operation of the San Carlos Institute in Santa Rosa de Copan. It sets the boundaries between the departments of Comayagua and Yoro. On December 16, 1875, General José María Medina from Gracias issued a proclamation to overthrow the president, General Ponciano Leiva. The political intervention of El Salvador and Guatemala in the hands of Andrés Valle and Justo Rufino Barrios, respectively, to impose Marco Aurelio Soto are the factor that explains the military defeat of General Ponciano Leiva. On June 8, 1876, he celebrated the Cedros Agreement with José María Medina, where they accepted the Marcelino Mejía to cover the executive. The mediation of Salvadoran Commissioner Cruz Lozano guaranteed compliance with the convention. After the signing, he retires to his private activities in Santa Cruz de Yohoa, his birthplace. Appointed Minister of War by President Luis Bográn in March 1891, as a result of the tragic events of the uprising of General Longinos Sánchez, summoned by the National Congress to general elections on March 18, 1891. The candidates, lawyer Policarpo Bonilla and Ponciano Leiva, encouraged their partials. On May 6, 1891, a bloody event occurred in Amapala. The Bográn government held the opposition responsible and declared a state of siege for more than 100 days. Held the elections between 4 and 6 of September 1891. The candidacy of Ponciano Leiva triumphed. The opposition demanded illegitimate results. President Bográn convinced the National Congress to meet on November 1st in the city of Comayagua. Installed on November 6 in Comayagua, he is preparing to declare Ponciano Leiva elected. On November 30, 1891, he lent his promise of law and is declared President of the Republic of Honduras. He founded the School of Law in Comayagua on January 25, 1891. Between November and December 1891, General Terencio Sierra tried to overthrow the government of Ponciano Leiva. He appointed Domingo Vázquez Commander of Arms of Tegucigalpa on April 2, 1891. To replace General Pablo Nuila, who conspired against the government, it expels leader of the political opposition. Decree state of siege in the departments of Tegucigalpa, Choluteca, Olancho, El Paraíso, Colón, and Yoro. Due to the conditions of military uprisings, he imposed measures of an emerging nature, such as confiscation of the assets of the rebels, issuing courts martials for the seditious and decreeing executions. It grants amnesty to all those involved in acts against the government. He moved the headquarters of the executive to Tegucigalpa on January 18, 1893, to report on the facts and progress of his administration. On February 9, 1891, citing health reasons, he deposits the president in deputy Rosendo Agüero. He retires to his private life. Congress suspends sessions because of threats of civil war. On February 9, 1893, he submitted his resignation as President of the Republic and the National Congress accepted it. This was a day in the history of Honduras.